Now let's have a look at another program that instead of text-based messages uses serialized objects. So this program is exactly identical to the one we've just seen, with the only difference that the message format is changed. The important things are in the net packages on the server side and the client side, and also in the common package. So in the common package, there is no more constants to format text-based messages, but instead there is this class. The messages now consist of objects of this class. So note that a class of which objects shall be serialized must implement serializable, Java.io serializable. Then we can create serialized representation and, for example, send them over the network. So this is a quite simple class, just has a type and the body properties, the same as the contents of the text-based message. Okay, so that's the new message format. Then let's have a look at the client side, server connection. So the difference is when messages are sent, that is the send MSG method. So no string manipulation now, we just create an instance of the message class and then write that by calling the writeObject method. So the toServer stream now is of type objectOutputStream that can serialize objects. Note that when you have sent an object, must also reset the stream. That is because objects are cached in the stream. So if later we send another object of the same class, we might get the state of the previous object. By reset, we discard the state of objects that have been previously sent. So that's the only difference on the client side. Instead of string manipulation, here in the send message method, we just send a plain object, one method, write object. So that's easier. Then on the server side, the difference is in client handler. So when objects are read, again, no string parsing and stuff, just call read object to retrieve the object that was sent from the client. And the same way when sending messages from server to client. Create an instance of the message class, write the object, flush to empty all the streams, make sure the message is sent, reset to be able to change state, not use cache state of the object. And on the client side, when it's received, just call read object. Yeah, so that's it. The code is simpler with using objects instead of strings, because we don't have to parse and construct strings, just serialize and deserialize objects. The downside, on the other hand, is that serialization is a bit slow. So such a serialized object protocol is generally slower. Also, if you want to look at the message being sent, it's not so easy to understand the serialized representation. If you want to see what's actually on the wire, it's not so easy to understand the serialized object compared to text-based message, if that is important.